let's go into these isms. The first ism was scientism. Now, what does scientism mean? Scientism essentially says that all truths, for them to be true, have to be proven by science. So science is the only method to render the truth about world and reality. Science is the only way to establish truth. Now, in the very beginning, you might think, well, that's true. Everything true must be scientifically proven. But this is wrong. This is a 1960s outdated philosophical cliche. You don't have philosophers or thinkers or just normal people with a brain saying that everything true must be proven scientifically. And let me give you some examples. Firstly, the claim itself is self-defeating. It's self-defeating. It shoots itself in the foot. Because to say that science is the only method to form conclusions about the world and reality, that statement itself, it's supposed to be a truthful statement. But that statement cannot be proven by science itself. So it's self-defeating. Because scientism says that the only way to prove things is to use a scientific method. But wait a minute, can that statement itself be proven scientifically? So it's self-defeating. Number two, science cannot prove necessary truths like mathematics. 1 + 1 = 2? Hello? Good. Okay, well, someone may say, well, if you get one thing and another thing, then you know they're two things. Okay, let me just make it easier for you to show that it's non-empirical. What is 1 fufula + 1 fufula? It's 2 fufulas. Do you know what a fufula is? Exactly. It's non-empirical, but there are logical structures in your mind that allow you to form that conclusion. Another point to refute the scientism claim is to talk about logic. There are some logical structures innate in our minds that allow us to form conclusions about things devoid of empirical realities. For example, listen to this logic. Number one, whatever begins to exist has a cause. Number two, the universe began to exist. Number three, the universe has a logicians. MashaAllah. Now that conclusion itself is non-empirical, because what allows us within our minds to form that necessary conclusion? Where is that logical link? It's outside of the empirical domain. It's logical structures in our mind. Science also, or scientism, cannot prove aesthetic and moral truths. Take love, for example. What did the famous poet say about love? When the pen writes of love, it breaks in two, because you can't really express yourself. But according to a materialistic scientific paradigm, love is like having lots of chocolate. Imagine going to your wife and saying, darling, I love you. And she just looks at you scornfully and says, it's no more equivalent than having loads of chocolate. It's just chemicals in your brain, right? Intuitively, you know that doesn't make sense. Take concepts of beauty and morality. These things don't have a scientific basis. They are non-empirical, especially when you talk about morality, because science is amoral from that perspective. It tells you what is, it doesn't tell you what ought to be. Also, science cannot prove other sources of knowledge like testimony, because if you study epistemology, I know it's a big word, all it means is the study of knowledge. When you look at the study of knowledge, you see that testimony, the authentic say-so of others, is a valid form of knowledge. For example, who believes China exists? Put your hand up. Who's been to China before? Hardly anyone. Who could speak Chinese? Ni hen piao liang. I said he's very pretty. MashaAllah, tabarakallah. So the point is, many of us know China exists, but we've never been to China before. We've never spoken to a Chinese person in China, never had Chinese food in China. All we've seen is someone who looks different that claims to be Chinese. And we've seen some restaurant that says Chinese food. And on Google Maps, it says China. All of this is testimonial. It's non-empirical. But we will bet our lives that China exists. So it shows that a lot of our knowledge is established by the say-so of others. So scientism is a false presupposition when atheists say, well, it has to be proven scientifically. Or when materialists say, well, it has to be proven scientifically. You just have to show to them, You're assuming scientism to be true. That's the only way to form conclusions about life and reality, and that's simply not true. Does this make sense so far? You sure? Good.